We want to expand each logarithm as much as possible using our properties of logarithms given here below. Notice both of our logarithms contain square roots, so the first step will be to write everything in exponent form. Remember, a square root has an index of 2, so we can write this as the common log of x to the fourth. We could write this as the square root of y to the fourth all over the square root of z to the fifth. And again, since the index is 2, we can write this as common log of x to the fourth times, this would be y to the power of 4 divided by 2, or y squared, divided by z to the 5 halves. And we could actually multiply these together if we wanted to. Remember, x to the fourth is the same as x to the fourth over 1. So we could write this as the common log of x to the fourth, y to the second, divided by z to the 5 halves. Notice how we have a product in the numerator, and we also have this fraction, which is a quotient. Let's start by expanding this by dealing with this quotient. If we have log of x divided by y, we can write this as a difference of two logarithms. So this is equal to the common log of the numerator, which is x to the fourth, y to the second, minus, because of the quotient, the common log of z to the 5 halves. And now we can expand this first logarithm because we have a product here. So this will expand it to the sum of two logs. This is equal to the log of x to the fourth, plus, because of the product, common log y squared minus log z to the 5 halves. And then for the last step, we can apply this power property of logarithms, so we can take the exponents and move them to the coefficients. So this is equal to 4 log x plus 2 log y, this would be minus 5 halves log z. This is considered the expanded form of the given logarithm. And now for our second example, the first step will be to rewrite this as natural log of x to the eighth, and then we'll have the quantity x minus 3 to the 1/2 power because of the square root of the quantity x minus 3, and our denominator is the quantity x plus 4. And now because we have a quotient here, we would have the natural log of the numerator minus the natural log of the denominator. So we have natural log of x to the eighth times the quantity x minus 3 to the 1/2 minus natural log of the denominator, which is the quantity x plus 4. Now, it may be tempting to expand this into a sum of two logs, but we cannot do that because it would only expand to a sum if we had a product here, and this is a sum. So we cannot apply this first rule here, but since we do have a product here, we can expand this first logarithm into a sum of two logs. So this is equal to the natural log of x to the eighth plus, because of the product, natural log of the quantity x minus 3 to the 1/2 minus natural log of the quantity x plus 4. And now our last step is going to be to expand this using the power property of logarithms. So we can take our exponent here, move it to the front, and this exponent here, and move it to the front. So we would have 8 natural log x plus, this would be 1/2 natural log of the quantity x minus 3 minus natural log of the quantity x plus 4. And again, I know it's tempting to try to expand this logarithm into a difference in sum, but we can't do that because we can only expand into a sum or difference if we have a product or a quotient of the number part of the logarithms. So this is as far as we can go, and this would be considered the expanded form of the given logarithm. Okay, we'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.